I am back after 2 days, so obviously my paper has dried completely. I have gotten a lot of gardening done while I was away, and we're ready to go again. This is the part that I enjoy the most. I really love putting the detail into these flowers. This has dried pretty much the way that I had wanted it to. I've got some lines kind of going down this way, which was a little surprise, and I'm not unhappy with that. I've got a little bit deeper colors up here and lighter down here, and that's what I was going for. Now I'm going to start the third of either 3 to 4 coats, depending on each individual flower, and I'm going to start putting in the dark detail. I'm going to add 2 colors to my palette, the palette I'm using. They're going to be my White Nights Indigo and Indanthrene Blue. These, and I have a neutral black up here. These 3 colors, I won't be using the black in this picture, but these 3 colors are indispensable to me. And the reason is, normally most paint brands will dry a lot lighter. And I am someone who just really loves a lot of depth and color. And without these 3 colors, which I mix in various, and I also vary them within the same picture so that I get some more interest, but I will use a mix of these for my dark colors, which I can put on once I know that the dark is going to stay there. I don't have to mess with it and go back for 20 coats or whatever it would have been. So those are the 2 colors I'm adding. I'm going to give them a little spray since everything has been drying for 2 days. And I am getting ready to go. So I'm going to use a slightly smaller brush. I think I will go with my... What brush will I go with? I would like... I'm going to go with a number 4 Blick Master Stroke. A little bit smaller, but still holds a good amount of water. And if this one... Looks like this one I'm beginning to wear the point down a little bit. And if it's not sharp enough, I will switch again. But I'm going to turn my paper on its side here. And I'm going to zoom in a bit so you can watch what I'm doing. Get this up centered. Okay. So I've got my 2 brushes. I will need my wash brush for this layer. So I absolutely will need that. And I've got my number 4 Blick Master Stroke. You know what? I think that this one has lost enough of a point that I'm not going to use that one. I'm going to go with my Fibonacci number, I thought it was a 2, but that doesn't look like it says 2. This is a nice pointed brush, but the one, and I really like it because it's very stiff, and it'll let me do very nice points. But the one thing that it does that's quite disconcerting is it will store a couple drops of water up in the bristles up here. And you think you're doing fine, and you're going along, and all of a sudden those flow out onto the paper, and you've got a puddle. So when I first got this, I fell in love with it, but it keeps doing that. So I'm going to try a little bit with it, and we'll see how far I go before it does that, and I have to stop. All right, so I'm going to be working with my deepest color here. So the first one I'm going to take is a little bit of violet, And I'm going to just enhance this violet area. And some of the areas are going to be sharp, as I said, and some are not. So I'm just, each individual flower is going to have its own thing going on. And I am going to assume that this is going to be my last coat on each one of the flowers. Now I'm going to dip just into my indigo here, and I'm going to highlight this darkest edge. Oh, it did it! It did it! Doggone it! Okay, that brush is out of there. I've got to pick it up. That is just too bad about those brushes, because it was such a nice brush. I just loved how stiff it was, and the point is ultra sharp. And now I've got to find a different brush. All right, I'm going to go with this number 3. Okay. And let me give it just since I got a big wash out there because of that drop coming down, I'm going to give it another little bit here and define, make some definition in the flower. It doesn't have to be anything like, okay, there's a petal over here and there's a petal over there. Just kind of give it some definition to make your eye want to look at it. And that's really what it's about. This is a figurative flower, I guess I would say, instead of a technically correct flower. Very pleasing to me. And actually to a lot of people, I know that this style is very pleasing to a lot of people. Because I get a lot, when I paint like this, I get a lot of, comments on it. That was my dog laying down next to me here. She started being very vocal. Now, again, I am just allowing my artistic intuition to guide me along on this. I don't have any picture to look at. I'm just creating some interest in each one of the flowers. All right. Now I used indigo on two of them. I'm going to go now with the indinthrine. And I want to keep varying it because it's just more interesting that way. This flower is in back of the other one. On my picture anyway. It may have turned out in front of the other one on your picture. And if so, paint it that way. Perfectly fine. A little bit of indinthrine. And I'll have to see if I like that enough to keep it there and without putting another coat of indigo on top. Since I've got indinthrine on my brush, I'm going to go up with it. Maybe in this one do a little bit of a line. And I'll just do a little bit of both. I'm going to mix the colors right in the pan. And now this one in back here, I'm going to leave until later because it's touching this one. So I'm going to have to leave it. So that the first petal is all the way dried before I put any water in that one. And so I'm just pulling the color out and letting there be a very deep spot at the bottom of the color, at the bottom of the flower. And I just feel like right now, I just feel like enhancing that depth. So I just took a little bit of pure indigo and I'm touching it in there on the bottom. And you see how that defines that flower? I'm going to come back later and work on the inside of this flower. I'm going to go with indinthrine on this one. And so really here, I'm just going to go ahead and paint, and you can, I'm actually going to turn on my music, because when I have my music on, and the type of music I like to listen to is very quiet kind of meditation music, I think I paint better. So I'm going to put my music on, and I would encourage you to put yours on, and let's just paint for a while. Going to be brave, and I'm going to take this brush back again, making sure that I have gotten all the water out that I can, because I want its fine point to do this. On this, I am going to have the idea of some stamens in this one. So to do that, I paint around the stamens. It's sort of a very loose, made-up way. I'm going to have kind of a light spot down there. Okay, now I'm going to take my number 3 brush. It's a little pointier than my wash brush. and I'm going to go in at the edge of this, and I'm going to pull that edge out, and then it becomes the center of a flower. Very easy way to do your flower centers. And just pull that out. It's just going to shade those lower petals, which is exactly what you want. That was my indigo. And I use indigo for that normally. And I've got it just a little bit light in there, so I'm going to go back in. And where I've already got the paint, it's still wet, and it's just going to run and fill in the gaps if I just touch it where I've already painted, where it's still wet. See, isn't that nice? That's so effective. There I go. I've got some stamens and some depth. Your eye's drawn to that. Perfect. That's what I wanted. I'm going to put this dangerous brush away before I keep using it and have a problem. So I'm just going to let that dry. That flower is going to have a little bit more. I'm going to come back and do some more on that one. I've got some indigo here. I want to darken this one a little bit. Okay. All right, so I am going to stop talking for a little bit, and let's just paint. Thank you. Here I'm starting with indenthrine, and I think this is probably a good way to do it. Start with a lighter color, and then come back and drop in either a thicker mix of indenthrine, or maybe a mix of between indenthrine and indigo. And don't forget to use your violet sometimes in this layer as well, just to add some extra interest. I just love this contrast. My eyes are so drawn to this kind of figurative looseness that has a lot of changes in value. Here I started with indenthrine here, a light wash with that. What I put in next was the indigo, and I'm going to drop a little bit of indenthrine in to give it some more blue. See how that works? Pretty wet. It's going to go as far as I went with the water. I better go a little bit further because I think it's going to stop too soon. And I'll just go ahead and go outside the blinds here. But isn't that pretty? I love that. I'm going to define the bottom of this flower a little bit right here by doing the same thing. And use my wash brush to pull it up, being careful not to reach over into that so that that can run in here. I want this to be separate, and that's why I also used a different color. I want there to be some color variation here. Okay, now I have got a this flower. And this flower are both facing away, and as is this one too. These three are all facing away, and so they aren't going to have the interior depth. So I'm going to make them lighter, a lighter color, and I'm going to actually put a little bit more of my sky blue, bright blue. On here, just a little touch on the top, which will help our eyes to understand that this flower is getting a little bit more light than the other ones. It's sticking out away from the stem. And when you're doing this, be careful. Make sure that you're getting your water far enough out. Try going at least twice as far as you think that paint is going to flow, because you're going to be going along working on something else, and suddenly you'll look back and your paint has dried into a line. So just right away, give it a place to go that's further than you think it will have to go. Okay, I've got some bright blue. I'm going to go with a little bit of my ultramarine in here. That was pretty thick, dry, but that's okay. I put more water on it. And I'm adding a little bit more down below here. This is going to be a much paler flower because we're looking at the back. Okay, let's do the same thing down here. Just a little bit of bright blue up here on the top, but I don't want to define that quite so much as that. Again, I'm going much further out than I think I need to. because I don't like having to scrub those lines away. And now I've gone with my ultramarine down here. And I think, whoops. I think I'm gonna just pull it around over here. And I'm going to put a little touch of violet back in here. I just think it could use a little bit. And let that just kind of wander where it wants to. Don't forget we've got a little bit over here too on the other side of this stem. So treat it the same way. A little bit of ultramarine. And then let's just, just a tiniest little dab. A violet, just to continue that flower over here. Make sure you're lined up. Your line goes straight through that. Sometimes detail's great, and sometimes we leave it off. And that's what makes this kind of picture interesting, because it all makes sense where the detail is. But then you have all of this latitude to fill in the rest of the picture in your mind. That's why this one works so well. On the bottom of this flower, this one's in a lot of shade. So I'm going to, instead of using those colors, I'm going to go with some indanthrene here. And really shade this one in fairly much. Now remember to watch your painting areas and don't paint up against another wet area. But if you do that, if you accidentally do that, in this picture, kind of picture, it's okay. You just use that as a happy accident. Okay, I've got that started. Good.